Dr. Muhammad Aslam, Rector, UMT, Professor Abid Keshav Sherwani, Muhammad Nusrat Ali Chishti, Secretary, the Textile Institute, Lahore Section, and distinguished guests. Good morning and Assalamu Alaikum. It's a matter of great privilege for me to be called upon to address the 6th International Conference of Textile and Clothing 2019 at UMT. I would like to congratulate the management for organizing this conference on textile and clothing. The conference will provide stakeholders of the textile industry and technologists an insight to new ideas and trends of sustainability in the textile and clothing production. I hope the conference would give us a better understanding with regard to the utilization of synergies for bringing diversification in our production and manufacturing activities. I would like to talk a little bit about APTMA and give you a little some facts. APTMA is the premier textile association working for the protection promotion of textile industry in Pakistan. Members of APTMA represent the entire value chain and contribute to more than 50% of the total exports of textile exports of Pakistan. APTMA is the founder member of Better Cotton Initiative, that's called as BCI in Pakistan, and it plays an important role in representing textile mills in Pakistan to promote measurable improvements in the key environmental and social impacts of cotton cultivation. BCI process makes cotton economically, environmentally, and socially sustainable. APTMA has also established Sustainable Production Center, or SPC, in collaboration with GIZ, a German organization, to promote sustainable production practices in the textile industry, especially in energy conservation. Another fact that the textile industry is the dominant manufacturing sector in Pakistan. It remains the mainstay of our economy. The textile industry contributes 46% of the manufacturing sector, 88.5% to the GDP, and 58% of the total country's export. It provides direct employment of over 3.5 million people, which is approximately 38% of the workforce in the manufacturing sector. There's a lot of talk about cotton, and you know, we are, as an industry, we are dependent on cotton and not synthetics. That is correct. And cotton is an important cash crop for Pakistan and significantly contributes to the economic growth and development from, you know, starting from the agriculture and the whole chain. And Pakistan is the fourth largest producer of cotton and the third largest consumer of cotton and has a very important position in the world cotton market. For the past few years, Pakistan's cotton economy could not perform as per its potential, owing to different reasons, including shortage of water, climate change, poor quality seeds, pesticides, and most importantly, lack of research, which has created a deficit of approximately 4 million bales for the textile industry, and we are importing cotton from the United States, India, Egypt, CIS states, Afghanistan, and pretty much everywhere. And at the same time, due to adverse government policies, the textile industry has not grown in product diversification, especially in synthetic textiles, because we are subjected to import duties on raw materials that are not being produced in Pakistan. Hence, we have not been able to diversify the product mix, and it's not competitive to produce these synthetic products. That, whereas, you know, in the world, approximately 65% share in the textile and clothing market is synthetics. In Pakistan, it is the opposite. Similarly, the industry has also strived hard for its survival in the last 5 years, owing to high cost of doing business. That's led to closure of 30% production capacity, primarily in basic textiles, because basic textiles is energy intensive, and the majority of the industry is located in Punjab, and because of the disparity and the 18th Amendment, we had no gas in Punjab. So we were, the industry in Punjab was subjected to or was forced to use more expensive fuels and thus did not remain competitive within the country and within the region. The current government, however, has introduced export-friendly policies due to which business scenario is rapidly changing. Industry is keenly looking to forward to invest and in technology upgradation and value addition. We, with encouragement and support by the government, the industry is targeting to double textile and clothing exports to $26 billion in the next 5 years. An investment of $7 billion is required to double our exports, that, and that investment would be primarily targeted to set up new garment factories and focus on the value addition and converting the basic textiles into of the final product. So subject to enabling environment made available to the industry, investors are looking forward to take BMR expansions and greenfield investment projects in all subsectors of the textile value chain. The government has recently formed a task force for the preparation of long-term textile policy to set direction for achieving these goals. I would like to call upon all education and research institutions in the field of textiles to join hands to create synergies between academia and industry and to work in tandem. Propose steps for overcoming the challenges ahead and to come up with a strategic plan for the long-term sustainability and growth of Pakistan's textile sector. By highlighting the latest research, newest technologies, and the most recent business applications in textiles and clothing, this conference may help Pakistan's textile sector to prepare itself for the tough global competition ahead. We have a $13 billion additional export potential if we convert our basic textiles into garments, home textiles, or the finished products. And also, we need to revive the closed capacity, which is estimated to be around $2.5 billion. So if we convert that capacity and add value and invest another $7 billion in the next 5 years, we can achieve a $26 billion target of textile exports alone for the country. We should not be deterred by the challenges before us with industry research institutes and academia working hand in hand with the government. I am very confident that, inshallah, we shall overcome the difficulties and build a vibrant, strong, and globally competitive industry in Pakistan. In the end, I would like to extend my well wishes for the success of this conference.